Hey everybody, I just thought I'd make a quick little video here and kind of tell you what I've been up to. I've been a little bit slow with the car videos here. There's been a few days in between them lately, and that's partly because of the weather, because it's been so cold and icy out and that kind of thing, but also because I've been painting again. And so I thought I'd show you a little bit of what I've been working on. I know a lot of my new subscribers probably aren't even aware that I do paintings. That's because I haven't really done any videos on that for quite a while. So I thought I'd show you my kind of work in progress here and maybe some of my old stuff so you can get an idea. This actually on the wall here is one of my favorite paintings that I've done in the past. As you can see, it's just a toy little race car, wind-up race car. But the reason I like that one is just because it's really clean and simple. And for me, that's actually a much more difficult thing to do, is to make something just very clean and crisp. And you know, the right correct dimensions, and you know, I don't have a lot going on in there to hide any mistakes or anything, so it has to be done as well as possible, that's for sure. Then in the past I've done a series of these kind of folk art style landscape paintings, and because I'm into cars, I always put a car in the front in the foreground, and then some elements, you know, carry over from painting to painting. Like I always put a church up top. That's just something I started doing. Then you're gonna have your various farmhouses and things. Usually there's some, you know, people walking around. In this case, there's a cat there. I've done that twice now. I actually put a cat in a painting for my friend Ken over at 1963 Impala two-door here on YouTube. This particular painting has a 46, I think it's a 46 Pontiac Silver Streak there. And you know, these aren't based on any actual location, obviously, or any photographs, so it's just kind of my interpretation of a rural landscape. It's just kind of made up off the top of my head, and I did these sort of in a series, so I have a lot of paintings that look somewhat similar, but no element is actually the same. Here's another one actually down here that I was using sort of as a reference. On this one, you can see I had these really kind of primitive, very simple clouds, just a very much a folk art style there. But then on some of these other ones, the clouds become more realistic. And I kind of go between the two, between being a little more realistic and a little less, just trying to figure out, you know, how I want them to be. So, and actually in my office here, I've got artwork all over the place. This particular one is not mine, but it's just really cool. I thought I'd show you a couple more I got in here before I get to the one I'm working on. Those are some old Scientific American covers. They've got some cool old machinery on there. That's why I like those. And then in here where I actually edit videos, I've got like 12-foot ceilings in here. So I've kind of made this like a little art gallery. And this is where I've got these series of paintings. You can see I got an old John Deere B tractor there. Very similar in style. Once again, with the very simple, primitive looking clouds in this one. There's one with like a 32, the apple farm there. This one's a Model T, but it's one of those old like farm delivery trucks. And you have like someone hanging clothes out on the line there. Got some cows in there, that kind of thing. Once again, a church up top. There's one over here. It's actually got like a mountain range here and a car coming down. And then again, very similar style in the background there. Got a lake in this one. Somebody's flying a kite there on the hill. That sort of thing. But anyway, I just thought I'd show you a few of those for those of you that don't know that I paint. And then I thought I'd show you this one that I've been working on here. In fact, let me go ahead and insert a little clip here so you can see where this sort of began. Alright guys, so you can see in that first clip, I'd kind of laid out the general layout, done a little sketching, got the car put in there pretty much, and then this is sort of the next phase where I've started laying in the base colors and sort of, you know, on the house, the barn, the car, basically getting everything kind of cemented into the place it's going to be. Now, you know, a lot of people like to think that artists just stand there and like it comes right off the brush into a perfect car. or house. And maybe there's some people out there that can do that, but I can't. So I actually do anything that's has to be the correct dimensions, you know, that I want to really look right, I do sketch out with pencil ahead of time. And then, you know, so that really helps everything look correct. Because there's nothing that I dislike more than having like a car and a painting and then something looks really wonky, where like the wheels oblong or one headlight's too big, or, you know, all that kind of stuff. So I try to get it as dimensionally correct as I can. In this particular one, that's actually a 36 Ford convertible. Now, obviously don't judge this yet, because all I did was lay some blue on there just sort of as a placekeeper. It basically just cements that image there so that when I go working on all the background and everything, I can work around it and that kind of thing. But the finished color will be much different than this, and there'll be a lot more detail in the car. The sky on this one, I chose to go a little bit more realistic with it as opposed to some of those more folky style ones. And then, but I do have the church up here again in this one. Again, I went with a little more realism in this one as far as perspective-wise. I made the church a bit smaller so you can judge the distance a bit better. Same with this distant farm back here. And then there's actually some hills even further back in the background. And when this is all done, generally speaking in painting, without getting into it too deep, if you kind of work your way from light to darker colors as you move forward, that'll give you a better sense of depth. So like in these greens, it's really hazy back here in the distance ones, and those can be kind of purplish because it's a really far off. And then you'll get a very bright color green here in the grass. As it moves forward, it's gonna get darker and darker. And then this will actually be far darker up front here in the foreground. And that'll give you a really good sense of distance to the painting when it's all done. The farmhouse and the barn, I did sketch those ahead of time, because once again, I just like to get the, it's not like Bob Ross where you just kind of like slap a wall in and, you know, where you're going for more of an impressionistic type look. I like it to be pretty realistic, so I did sketch that ahead of time. The distant ones, I can kind of just wing those a bit, you know, when I put those in. They don't have to be quite as detailed because they're going to be really far away, and there's going to be things actually obstructing your view to those before it's all said and done. I will say this, I don't paint in a very professional style as far as I'm an amateur, self-taught, so I found out what works for me, even if it's not technically correct. So that's the way I do things. Like one thing, I've taken this dark color, as you can see, which is just a mixture of blue and black, and because I don't like to use pure black, because you really don't see that in the real world. And then what I do is I lay out the basic places where the trees are going to be, and then obviously that's just a backdrop, and then I'll go over top of that with the greens and yellows and oranges or whatever I decide to do, and separate individual trees on top of that. This dark color just gives it like a three-dimensional look when it's all built up, you know, above that, and that's how I do that. And once again, with the same with the road, this road will actually go from light to dark as it moves forward, just again giving us some more depth to it. Hopefully this is showing up in here well enough. But anyway, I just wanted to kind of show you this preliminary phase before I show you the finished painting, so that you can see that I actually did do it. But anyway, I just wanted to show you what I was up to. And like I said, they always look like crap in this kind of middle phase here, and that's just part of painting. You got to kind of push past that, and you have to be able to kind of visualize what it's going to be when it's all finished. When this is all done, there'll be like a big wooden fence coming across here. Yeah, again, you know, your wooden fence will go from big to smaller, and that'll give you some more depth there. I'll have a big tree up here, which that's another little trick. And if you ever watch like Bob Ross or somebody like that, he likes to put a big tree up in the front. And there's a good reason for that. It's because when you put that big tree in the foreground, it pushes everything else back. And you, when it's all finished, you really do feel like you're looking off into the distance. And that's what I'll be you know, going for here, obviously. But anyway, most of you people that are into cars probably won't even find that very interesting, but I just thought I'd show you what I've been up to, because I have been kind of busy with that lately. And like I said, between that and the weather, I am actually heading out right now to Gateway to film a car or two, so I will have some videos coming up. So anyway, I thought you guys might find that interesting. Thanks for watching and commenting and everything, and I'll see you later. Bye.